and sleep.
We can definitely expect to see synthetic data become a lot more mainstream, similar to what we're seeing with generative AI these days. Organizations realize the need for data, yet in some cases are just restricted to what their organizations can actually use due to privacy issues. There are many ways to actually generate synthetic data. It could be by providing known statistical distributions to sample from. It could be by defining rules that encode logic that help generate data and then the values for attributes and enforce relationships among those attributes. There are, of course, algorithmic approaches to generate synthetic data. Many deep learning techniques like GANs or generative adversarial networks and other approaches like that that are really good at finding the complex patterns and understanding the patterns in actual data and replicating those in synthetic data that it can generate. And then there are AI-based techniques that use algorithms to generate data based off of patterns that it's understanding and finding in real data. So there are a number of ways that you can generate data to either supplement existing data or in some cases just completely fill gaps of missing data that you want to ensure that there's proper representation across all groups. The production and consumption of synthetic data definitely is not an easy button. Just like with AI applications in general, it all starts with ensuring that you have a good understanding of the problem you're trying to solve, the objectives you're trying to achieve, and take stock of what data you have and what data is missing that you can help fill those gaps with synthetic data. All along the way, you need to be mindful that there isn't any sort of leakage of privacy, and of course, ensuring that there's an appropriate balance of all groups represented in that data. And this is exactly what synthetic data is trying to help you achieve. Organizations spend a lot of time acquiring data, preparing data, cleaning data for their AI development efforts. And this is not a one-time process. This happens over and over again. So if a reliable synthetic data generation process can be put in place, this avoids a lot of that cost and that effort around data acquisition and preparation. And when put in place, the organization essentially can turn the crank on the data it needs at any given time. We're seeing synthetic data being used in a number of different industries. Within the government sector, it's all about people and processes and defining policies to provide services to the right people at the right time. And a big issue there, of course, is ensuring that we have proper representation, that those services and the decisions being made to apply those services are fair across the entire population. In healthcare, of course, there's a major concern about patient confidentiality and privacy all around that. And in the healthcare space and the life sciences space, that's probably one of the greatest opportunities for new discoveries with AI and advanced analytics that can be used to find new solutions, find new treatments for things like rare diseases where we don't have a lot of data for it. Regulatory bodies and policymakers are definitely taking note of synthetic data and the role it's playing in AI in helping drive innovation. There are standards being put in place, whether it's ISO, we've got GDPR, the EU AI Act, all of those are calling out some level of control over the use of synthetic data as part of this process to ensure that it's being used in an appropriate manner and it's following essentially the same sort of standards and guidelines that they're imposing on real data, if you will. We live in such a data-rich world these days. We're all feeding it daily, and organizations know that they need to take advantage of their data to fuel their AI efforts and drive intelligent, informed decisions. The reality is just because you have a lot of data doesn't mean that you have the right data or have access to the data that you need for those AI development efforts. And this is where synthetic data can really help, holding a promise for greater innovation and faster, more productive AI development.